you feel weak. You feel like you want to just give up. But you gotta search that in you. Find that inner strength. And just pull that shit out of you. And get that motivation to not give up. Till I collapse, I'm spilling these rats long as you feel them. To the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop killing them. And I am not
hip-hop. There we go.
Just not Eminem.
Keep on coming in, let's roll.
I'ma stop spinning them. Women are caught in webs. Spin them in heart, spin them, adrenaline shot.
How you doing? Happy Wednesday. Happy Wednesday. Thanks for joining. We got some people flowing in on Instagram. We got people flowing in on Facebook. Man, you got to get yourself jacked up if you want to close some deals, right? Man, you got to have energy in your meeting with your client. You can't go in cold. You can't go in with no energy. They're not going to want to see that. So what do you like to get yourself pumped up? That I just played you one of my favorite songs to get myself pumped up if you joined into the at the beginning of this. But we are going to talk tonight about forcing your win, about closing deals and getting business and shortening your sales cycle so that you can hit your goals. How's that sound? I'm literally going to give you the kitchen sink tonight. Are you ready for this? I'm going to give you the kitchen sink for shortening your sales cycle and closing deals. Hundreds of hours of studying, of courses, of 10 years of sales experience. We're gonna truncate this into about 35 minutes tonight. And this is for you. If you are in sales, if you are in a business and you need to sell a product or a service, this is night three if you have not joined in on the last two nights. This is the final night for now on our series of sales. We talked about know your value on the first night. We talked about showing your value last night. And tonight we're gonna finish with how to actually close the sales process, get your business, serve your clients, and everybody wins. So you cannot afford to wait. You cannot afford to wait. Most salespeople wait. They think they have the deal. I was in a meeting yesterday with somebody. They showed me their graph. They showed me all these accounts that they are prospecting, and they know they think they have a deal, and it's all this business, hypothetically. But you don't know. They didn't know if they actually had it or not. And then they showed me all the deals that they lost in the last 6 months. And what I want to ask you tonight, my first question for you, is how confident are you in your closing skills? On Instagram, if you want to give me very confident, somewhat confident, or I don't know how to do that, James. I can't wait to learn from you tonight. Let me know where you're at. I want to get some feedback from you guys on the live. And if you're watching the replay, feel free to answer the poll. Hopefully you can see that if you're on Facebook. But closing is different. Remember, first of all, closing is not sales, and selling is not closing. They are two different things. Just to be clear, selling is presenting an idea, pitching, conversation. You're doing your discovery of what's going on. Closing is a totally different tactic and skill that we're going to talk about tonight that most people don't develop, which is why they don't get the results that they want. And they struggle, and they get frustrated, and they don't know why they're not winning in their sales game, okay? So thank you for filling that out. So a couple things. You cannot afford to wait for your customer. You need to know for sure if they're in or they're out, because you can't have this guessing game over your head as you build this pipeline for months and a year and think you might get to your end goal, and most of the time you don't reach it. We got to get rid of that tonight. No more thinking, no more hypothetical. You're either going to know or you're just going to know. So we're going to talk about how you do that. You can't hope. can't hope that's just going to happen and you're going to get all this business because you send out email blasts or you go on a bunch of meetings and you've met and built some good relationships and people like you. That's not enough. You have to know. So how do you know? How do you know if you can get the business or not? Well, if you've tuned in, then the last two nights, we've kind of talked about the roadmap to getting to this point. Because once you get to the close, you should know for sure that you can close this person or business or not. And you should know if you can do it with integrity and you're the right person, you're the right company for what they need or not. So it's critical that you've done your homework, you've done the pre-meeting part correctly. Because if you have not done that, closing is going to be really difficult for you, and it's going to be hard to navigate because you haven't got all the information to have an effective conversation to make this thing happen or not. Okay, so we're going to talk about rewind for a second. Whoa, what is the roadmap, James? It's real easy. It's very simple. It's, do you understand their problem? In their words, have they told you what it is? Not you guessing. Have they told you what their problem is clearly? And you've verified it. You've confirmed you understand it. Number two is, have they told you what their ideal result is? What they want to see as their ideal dream come true? What the perfect scenario would be if they could have the fix to this problem that they have? Three is, what have they done to solve it in the past, if anything? And what hasn't worked? You're going to use that as ammo in a little bit. And you need to know if you can provide the result. That's it. If you know what they want and you know they have the problem and you also know that they've tried it before, the other question you want to ask is why now? Like what happens? What happens if you wait 6 months or 3 months? If you don't deal with this right now, is it that big of a deal? Or is it pretty bad? Is it catastrophic? Is it going to really hurt your business if you don't fix this right now? That's an important question. Because if they're telling you, we got to fix it now, then holy smokes, if they got to fix it now, you understand all those things, and you know you can deliver the result, then you got to close this deal right now. It is got to happen. And the things I want to talk to you about tonight, once you have that theoretically mapped out and we just did that exercise, once you do that exercise and you know yes or no, black or white, go forward or don't go forward, then there's a couple things that come up in salespeople when they try to have this conversation. And the biggest thing in all of sales, right, we all have this struggle is, well, what if they don't like me? Or the competition they have, what if we're not that much better? Or, you know, what if they're going to say no? What if they're going to say no? I hate getting told no. We have all these, or whatever it is, we have all these limiting beliefs that we tell ourselves in our head all the time, and we talk ourselves out of the deal half the time. It's not even real. So you got to control your limiting beliefs. Hi, everybody. We got some people from Mexico tonight. We got some people in Colorado on Instagram. Welcome. Thanks for joining. So you got to stop the limiting beliefs, guys. The closer's mindset is not the Wolf of Wall Street, okay? If you've ever seen that movie, it's an awesome, entertaining movie. Don't recommend anything of actual substance of what you should do in that movie for having integrity in your business. Great entertainment, but don't think of a closer as the Wolf of Wall Street, okay? Think of a closer, I'm going to say think of Yoda. Have you ever thought of Yoda as a closer in Star Wars? Probably not. But what kind of person does that look like? Well, it's someone that has sage wisdom, expert knowledge. They understand they understand the industry better than anybody. They're the master of the industry. They get it. They get the business. They know what they can do, and they know what's going on in the industry. Hi, Laura. Good to see you on tonight. So, and they're going to do the right thing, right? If you're an expert closer, you're a master of your craft. You are an expert in the industry. You're going to do the right thing. And that's half the battle. Okay. The last thing I want you to know about being a great closer, about closing the deal, closing equals help. Closing is professional. If you don't close deals, conversations, opportunities, when you have all that pre-work that we just talked about ironed out and it's check, 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 you were disservicing your client by not closing the deal. You should study more sales and closing, because you need to, it is professional and it's your obligation. If they need help and you can help them and they need it right now, you must close this. You must have this conversation and help them say yes and let's move forward. Okay. So how do you do that? Right? How do you do that? So we're going to talk about that. First of all, whenever we buy anything, now, if you today, let's just go through today. I'm pretty sure we all bought something today, right? You bought lunch, you bought maybe some Thanksgiving last minute items for tomorrow. You bought clothes for Christmas or whatever. You went shopping or you spent something today, most likely. And probably you just swiped your card or paid cash and you didn't even think about it, right? So we're not talking about easy transactional needs. That's a different conversation than we're having tonight. We're talking bigger. This is for people that are in going to an office every day. They're selling business to business products or services. And the sales cycle is a few weeks, a couple months, could be a year, but it's a little more complicated. And it takes a little more innuendo and craft and tactic to make this thing happen. Okay. So there's two things that a buyer and a company needs to have in order for them to pick you as their service provider. It's, does what you're saying make logical sense? Does it make complete sense? Like what you can do, how you're going to solve it, all your features and benefits, do they complement and help what they need and what they want? Yes or no? Logically, does it make sense? And two, is it emotionally, can they emotionally get themselves into this? Because what do we know about making big decisions? Buying a house, buying a car, buying anything that seems expensive in your head. You know, everyone's got different buying thresholds for stuff, but whatever seems big to you, you have to emotionally get into it. And it's hard to do that because what are we all apt to do? And this isn't business, this isn't personal life, right? Is we are abrasive to change, even if it's good, right? Even if it's good. So we have to ease this feeling of change and make it easy for them to feel like this is going to solve and feel so much better if I just start now. And we got to have that conversation. So how do you do that? We got to tip the scales and get rid of the barrier of this, oh, it's just so hard to change. It just seems like so much work. We've been stuck on this path for forever. I know what you're saying and it sounds great, but I can't even mentally think how we're going to do that because I have like 50 other problems that I'm also dealing with this at the same time. And I just feel stuck, right? So here's how you do it. You first remind them of, let's circle back to what we talked about before. All right. So before we get to that, real quick, you've done your homework. You've pitched your product or service, and the sale, like we talked about last night, begins when you ask for the business. So if you're in a meeting and you got a 30-minute meeting or an hour meeting or a 15-minute meeting, make sure you give yourself at least 40% time to get to that part, because you need the rest of your time to go through this next part. You need that time to have back and forth discussion, to handle this tough conversation. And most people, myself included, I've made this mistake hundreds of times. I would go through a whole meeting. I would do this amazing PowerPoint presentation or talk how great we are and we're the best and we can help you. And time's up and they got to go to their next meeting. And you know what? If you're in corporate, time is really thin. Time is really thin, and watch how hard it is to get back on that person's calendar. It may take you a month. It may take you 6 months. You must capitalize on the time you got with their attention. Attention is so critical, and we misuse it all the time. So I'm telling you this from painful and learning experiences, that you got to be more strategic with how you spend your meeting time, because we got to get to the second part, what we're going to talk about right now, and at least have 15, 20 minutes to talk about it. So now that we're there, we asked for the business. What do they say? All that stuff we just said, but man, we already have this vendor, and I got this other stuff, and you know, we're going through budgets and all these excuses, all these objections, right? It's just a deflection. That's all it is. Don't take it personally. Don't take any of this personally. What's happening right now is that they're trying to process what's going on with this, and they're experiencing that fight or flight of change, because it's really hard to get through that thought process and onto the other side if you can't navigate it with them. It's hard for them to come to that conclusion themselves. They're going to talk themselves out of it maybe within the meeting. So you got to have a moment where they are like, this is the perfect thing. Let's move forward. You got to get them there, and then you got to like push forward from there. And remember, this is not manipulative. This is not forceful. This is not without integrity. You were doing all this with integrity. You were doing all this with professionalism, with expertise, because it is your responsibility and your obligation to close the deal to help this person, because you can. That's it. So just remember that when you're in this, you got to have that mindset. Like you should never doubt once you're at this moment that this isn't the right thing to do. This is the absolute right thing to do. And your level of certainty with your energy and your emotion and your confidence and the way you're helping them talk will help them, because when they see you confident in this, it's going to help them feel a little bit more confident about where this is going. If you're not confident, there's no way they'll get confident. They will see your lack of confidence and bail in 2 seconds. Okay. So confidence is huge. But when they say no, or objection ABC, you have to remind them of what we've already discussed before, which is, well, you have this problem, right? Right. You tried to fix it before, didn't work. Right. Right. If you don't fix it now, it's going to cost you this, this, and this. Right. Yeah. Logic, 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 logic. You're boxing them in to a logical case that is 100% impenetrable. You can't, it's irrefutable. You make a logical case that makes sense that they can't refute. So you got them there. The second thing is they have this emotional hang-up still, right? So that's where you got to remind them of where they've been. Like, get them to tell that movie in their head and get them to speak it out loud. what's it been like for you to have this problem? Oh my gosh, like we have all these meetings every week. I go home stressed out every day. I really am starting to not like my job. I don't see how we're gonna get to where we wanna go with our goals if we don't fix this problem. All this stuff, get it out. Get this movie out and let them hear themselves say it, right? And then I want you to grab that junk, throw it out, and say, all right, now that we got that out of the way, let's look at where we're gonna go, okay? And start to paint a positive, different movie and help them see where this can go. So this is where, you know, being a visionary or being, you know, telling a story is extremely impactful in your ability to get this business. Telling a story is so powerful when you are using it in your meeting and you're trying to close this deal, for them to see and visualize where are you coming from and how can you actually help us and what will this look like. The more you can tell a story and paint a picture of where this is going, it will become much easier for them to see a totally different outcome than what they've been used to. Because they're only used to what they've been tunnel visioned in this whole time. And you're coming in trying to say, hey, that's not reality. You don't have to live like this anymore. You can go over here and it can be totally different. It can be totally better. So this is really where you got to give that amazing picture of, look, and get rid of their fears, right? Remember we talked about change is so hard in a company. There's multiple stakeholders that are involved in decisions and they have to talk after your meeting and to themselves and talk it over. And there's always one person that's got the ear, by the way. There's always that one person that's got the ear of the room, that's got the weight, that's the spokesperson for this deal. That person, whoever that is, you need to, hopefully you know who it is, but that person's got to speak the rooftops about what you're about and to say to them, their own constituents, this, we got to do this. We got to do this because we have no other option. You want that person to think it. You want that person to say it to their own team. And hopefully they say it to you. That'd be even better. But so you paint the positive picture and you talk about the things that they've already mentioned as objections. You get those out of the way. You hit those right now. So like if they're saying, man, we have all these other vendors, we're going through budget, it's just a lot. I don't know if we can do this right now. Now you're going to paint a story that blows all that up, right? You know, our solution is extremely easy to implement. It's literally paint by numbers. It's so simple. It's one call or one hour or whatever. Make it simple. Show them that when they make this decision, it is the easiest thing in the world to get started because that lowers the angst of not wanting to do this. It makes it a lot easier to stomach it and say, okay, well, if it's not that hard to implement, that sounds pretty good. Remind them of where they've been. They're using someone else that they compete against you with. Well, it ain't working. We're better. Why are we better? Social proof. Bring in your guns, not real guns. Bring in your stories, bring in your ammunition, bring in your testimonials, your clients that are just like them. Show them results. This client started, here's the result. This client started, here's the result. This client started, here's the result. The more you can show, the more consistent you can be. Boom, boom, boom. See, this is what it could look like. It can be the same for you too. And it didn't even take them that long. It took them whatever. Measurement around this stuff, right? Come in with measurement, with tangible ROI, and make it irrefutable, okay? But show them those case studies so that they can be like, wow, that makes a lot of sense, and you're saying it's easy. And then if you can, have an unbelievable promise. If you can do a guarantee or if you can do some type of big, bold claim that sounds too good not to pass up, you want to offer that here for it to just be a no-brainer. and you got to think through what that may, what that is for your business. But if you can have an unbelievable, like no-brainer, bold promise or claim that says, hey, if you sign today, this is what we're going to do, like guaranteed, like it will happen for you. If you can somehow give a certainty level with that, that will make it so much easier for you to actually get this done. So, and the last thing is I want to talk for a second about status. So this is something that I've known for a while, but Seth Godin, who I met a few weeks ago, he's an amazing author, best-selling 19 best-selling books. Seth Godin, he just wrote This Is Marketing. It just came out. It's in bookstores. I'm going through it right now. My favorite book that he wrote is called Tribes, by the way. If you guys have ever read his books, Tribes is one of my favorite leadership books. It really was impactful for me to read that. But he talks about we all as people have status. And he gave a story as an example of when there was a time in his life where he ran a kids camp. And the kids camp was excellent. It had the best quality camp. They had an excellent experience year after year. But over time, the business just wasn't doing that well. And the finances, the numbers weren't going up. They were on the threshold of going out of business. And so Seth had to make a tough choice of like, well, we got a great product. We got a great camp. Kids love it, but the numbers aren't there. What do we do? And what he did is he tripled the price of the camp. Bold move. What happened? Well, the kids and the parents that used to come, most of them stopped coming. But what ended up happening after that is this whole other tribe, this whole other group of people that felt, wow, that's an expensive camp for my kid. I like to send my kids to expensive camps. This looks like a great place for me to send my kid. And they got Seth got all this new demographic of people to come in into his camp, and his camp was profitable, crushed the revenue numbers, the top line, and they can continue servicing and having a great camp. Why do I tell that story? Because a lot of times I've done it, you've done it, we've all gotten and taken business and done business with clients that if we were honest with ourselves, if we scaled that out, if we had that same kind of client over and over and over and over and over again, we're not going to get to our goals of where we want to go, right? We're not going to get to our goals. The only way you can grow and scale super fast, it's not rocket science. It's really, you got a few options. You either raise your price, you either get more volume of business, or you get longer contracts to get your revenue stream longer. That's it. Like, that's what you got to do. It's not rocket science. It's not mysterious. That's one of those three things or all three. So you need to decide, going back to what we talked about on the first night, knowing your value. If you pick and narrow in on what are you the best in the world at in your industry, better than anybody, then you should absolutely raise your price a lot, because you can go in with confidence and say, all these other people, I know you work with them, but they don't do this. They don't do it like we do it. And here's why. And you build your social proof. You build your results. You get one client. You service the heck out of them. You over-deliver. You get that result. Then you use that and get the next big client. And then you build, and then you build, and then you build. And you just continue to scale this amazing track record of results that fit your price model, that fit your claim, that fit your niche. And there you go. And now you can take what took you 24, 12, 12 months, you know, in that time frame, you can start to scale those results that you used to get in that time frame into 6 months, into 3 months. and really get humming, because I mean, it's math. You get a deal that you used to charge $5,000 for, now you're charging $15,000 for it. You're going to turn a lot of people away. Yeah. But you're also going to get some people that have a different status that say, wow, that service is really expensive. I'm kind of curious about it. We're really good. I like to work with people that are of caliber like me. I'm going to buy that. It's a status thing. It's in the heads, I'm telling you. Seth talks about this all the time. It's a status thing. Companies are very proud of who they are and what they can do, and they want to work with the best, and they have the best vendors. And I'm not saying raise the price just to be schemey. I'm saying this is all with integrity, okay? But it all fits. It all fits. So if you want to go from 0 to 90, hit your goals in 90 days, you totally can do it. It's not fallacy. It's not crazy. I've done it. I have done it myself. I have done year after year of sales cycles that get me to President's Club in my company, and it's taking me 12 months almost to the last day. I've had years where it's been the last day and I tipped it over and I got my goal. And then when I finally changed all my strategies to what I've been telling you tonight and the last few nights and applied those instead, raised my price way, way higher, over-delivered, provided value, gave this client the best service they've ever had, ever, and made sure, I wanted to leave no question in this person's mind, in this company's mind. They have never seen what we brought. And they'll never see it again because they won't have to. They're going to work with us forever. We are long-term trusted advisors for this company. And that's the mindset you got to have when you want to grow your business, is you're confident to the core of who you are, what you can do, what can you deliver. You understand your client better than anybody because you're not being a Joe Schmo just spraying and praying and trying to get business everywhere and not really doing the work. There's so many people that do that. You are better than that. And your clients can tell. They can tell. They can tell in the first meeting. They can see it. It's not crazy. So I hope that helped you tonight. We went a little bit over. It's about 33 minutes. But if you want to force your win, go back and watch this again. Go back to the first two nights and watch those. Guys, I am giving you sound business strategy that works, okay? I just wrote a best-selling book about this. I'm going to give it to you as a free gift tonight for those that are watching. It's posted if you're on Instagram. If you go to my profile, I put the link in there. You can click on it. It's coming out December 13th. But if you want to reserve your copy today, you can get on the list, and we'll make sure you get that copy. It's free if you get it tonight. Instagram or Facebook, I put the link in the thing there. So take advantage of that if that will help you. If you would like more help, my first offer is to just get the free book. It's going to be out. I actually have to spend the rest of my night tonight finalizing the edits on it because I have to turn it into my editor tomorrow, and then we're off and running. But if you want more help than that, message me. Direct message me on Instagram or Facebook. Free call. I won't pitch you. I just want to hear what's going on in your business. If you want my help beyond that, we can talk. But if you just want a 30-minute call to talk about what's going on in your business, I'm game. Let me know. I'm here to help you. This is why I'm doing this. I am here online to help you guys with what you are going through in your sales and with your business. And I want to see you win. I want to see you win. So thanks for joining tonight. Have a happy Thanksgiving, and I will be in touch soon. Take care.